हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज डॉक्टर यसर दंडवते. आई वेलकम यू टू दी फिफ्थ वीडियो ऑन इंटरफेरेंस. इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट वन ऑफ द एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ इंटरफेरेंस, दैट इज एंटी रिफ्लेक्टिंग थिन फिल्म कोटिंग्स. एट द एंड ऑफ दिस लेक्चर लर्नर्स विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड वर्किंग एंड यूजफुलनेस ऑफ एंटी रिफ्लेक्टिंग कोटिंग्स. सो यू माइट बी अवेयर अबाउट द कोटिंग्स इन कैमरा लेंसेज और कोटेड सोलर सेल्स और लेंसेज, कोटेड लेंसेज इन बाइनोक्यूलर्स और ऑप्टिकल डिवाइसेज लाइक प्रिज्म और कॉन्वर्जिंग लेंसेज विच आर कोटेड इन नेचर. सो बाई विच मटेरियल दिस डिवाइसेज आर कोटेड? दिज आर कोटेड बाय एंटी रिफ्लेक्टिंग थिन फिल्म्स. सो डेफिनेटली देर इज सर्टन रोल ऑफ दिस एंटी रिफ्लेक्शन कोटिंग्स. सो द मेन पर्पज इज टू एनहांस, दैट इज टू इंक्रीज द ट्रांसमिटिविटी ऑफ द मटेरियल लाइक ग्लास. ऑन ग्लास इफ द एंटी रिफ्लेक्शन कोटिंग इज अप्लाइड, देन द ट्रांसमिटिविटी ऑफ द ग्लास इज इंक्रीज्ड. ऑल्सो इट डिक्रीजेस द लॉस ऑफ लाइट विच मे बी देयर ड्यू टू रिफ्लेक्शन. एज वी नो दैट वेन लाइट फॉल्स ऑन द ट्रांसपेरेंट मटेरियल लाइक ग्लास, it is partly reflected and partly refracted. That means whatever the intensity of incident light is divided equally or unequally into two parts. Some part is reflected, some part is transmitted. And thus, as far as the transmittivity is concerned, the intensity of the transmitted light is affected due to reflection of light. So, using anti-reflection coating, this loss of light due to reflection can be minimized. That will enhance the intensity of transmitted light. So this is the purpose of the anti-reflecting films. Now there are certain requirements for the material to act as anti-reflecting coating. The material should be transparent to light. It should adhere well with glass. It should uniformly spread on glass so as to form the thin film of uniform thickness. It should not be soluble in ordinary solvents. And these last two conditions are very important. The material which is to be used as anti-reflecting material, its refractive index should be greater than air but less than glass. And commonly used material is magnesium fluoride, which has refractive index 1.38. We will discuss about it very soon. One more condition is required, that is regarding the thickness. The thickness of the film should be of the order of lambda by 4 mu, where mu should be intermediate between air and glass, and lambda is in general taken as 5500 angstrom units, for which our eyes are most sensitive. Now let us see how exactly it works from the physics point of view. Consider a glass slab which has refractive index about 1.5. It is coated with magnesium fluoride. Outside medium is air having refractive index 1. So there are 3 media. Let us assume that light is falling on the upper surface of the film, at which it will be partly reflected and partly refracted. Again, from this point, see, it falls on the lower surface of the film and the next medium is glass, so it will be again reflected back and it will pass through air. So this way we get these two interfering rays as reflected rays and these two as transmitted rays. Alright, now look at the top surface of the film. The interface is between air and film. That means it is rarer to denser, and according to Stokes law, whenever this light is reflected, see here, look into the diagram. When this light ray is reflected from denser medium, that is film, it will have additional path change by lambda by 2. What about next interface, which is between film and glass? That means for this reflected light ray, do we have same condition? Yes, it is. Because when this light is reflected from the glass surface, it is also having same interface between film and glass, and hence Stokes' law suggests that this ray will also have the same path change by lambda by 2. So when these two reflected rays are interfering with each other, they are having equivalent change in the path difference, and hence it will cancel each other. Now let us see little mathematical part behind it. So the question is, though we say that the thickness of the film is lambda upon 4 mu, but how it comes out to be this? Let us see. As already I have stated that the wavelength for which these anti-reflection thin films are designed is 5500 angstrom minute. The question is regarding thickness. Refractive index is between air and glass. Okay. Now let us apply our known theory of parallel film, thin parallel film. Already in previous videos we have seen that for thin parallel sided film, the path difference is 2 mu t cos r. Now, further, according to Stokes' law, at both the interfaces as path is changing equivalently. Therefore, if we consider the effective path difference, it will remain same. There is no plus minus lambda by 2 as it cancels. So, this is the effective path difference 2 mu t cos r. Now, if we consider that this light is falling on the film almost normally. So, r becomes 0 and therefore, the path difference is only 2 mu t. So, we can write one more type of path difference as we want to have non-reflecting type of effect. That means, though these rays are reflected from the film, they should act as non-reflecting. So, when it will act as non-reflecting? When it fulfills the condition of destructive interference. Because we know that in destructive interference, the intensity of light becomes 0. It drops down. That means, somehow, if the light rays are destructively interfering, the corresponding intensity will be minimum and this is our desired condition. And for interference to be destructive, we know the path difference. Delta is equal to 2n plus 1 lambda by 2, or at least it should be of lambda by 2, odd number multiple of half wavelength. So, by considering equations 1 and 2, we can write 2 mu t is equal to lambda by 2, or t is equal to lambda by 4 mu. So, this way we can say that when the material is deposited on glass to act as anti-reflection film, the refractive index should be between air and glass and the film should have thickness of the order of lambda by 4 mu. Effect can be improved by applying multi-layer coatings. There is concept of single layer coating and multi-layer coating. So, using multi-layer coatings, better results are obtained. This is about anti-reflection thin film coatings. In the next video, we will discuss about the remaining applications of interference. Thank you.